Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make a lemon tart. It's a lemon curd which you pour into a cooked tart cases and let it sit in the fridge. For me, personally, it's the best. Because you still have this sharpness, it's not too sweet, and you really taste the lemon. It's really a good one. So, you start by melting some butter. You need 250 grams of butter. Yeah, to melt in a pan. Check. For the time being, so we're gonna need lemon zest. So we're gonna use 2 lemon zests. And that's already some lemon. I zested it another day, so I can just get the juice from it. Yeah. So we need 300 grams of juice. There we go. So we're gonna get 300 grams of that juice. I sieve it to remove all the pulps and stuff. There. Yeah. I'll finish for that. Up. That's my 300 gram. 2 zest in there as well. The butter is melting nicely. It's very nice, the lemon zest smell. Oh, we could smell this all day, you know. Lovely. There. Nice. Let's check the butter. Yeah, nearly all melted. You want to melt it, but not hot. I mean, you melt it, but keep it warm, not too hot. We can make ready 500 grams of caster sugar. A bit more. There. And once all the butter is melted, you put your caster sugar into it. Voilà, like that basically. Put your sugar. Now out of the stove, you're gonna add 4 eggs. Make sure it's not too hot. No, it's not. Otherwise, it will cook straight away your eggs. That's why you need to make sure it's not too hot. So, 1, stir it quickly, because your bottom of the pan is still quite hot, isn't it? Voilà. And once your first egg has been in, it's fine. Don't worry about anything. But keep doing one by one. Voilà. And the last one. Back on the stove. Voilà. back on the stove with the lemon juice and zest. Voilà. And now we're gonna cook it until a big boil. And once it's boiling, it's ready. Okay, see, now it's boiling. But you had to keep stirring it all the time, otherwise it's burning very quickly, this mix. But now it's boiling. You need a bigger boil than that, basically. Yeah. Don't forget to stir. Et voilà. Now it's boiling, that means it's ready. We can take it off of the heat. Here. Let it set a little bit and then you can pour it into your tart cases you done earlier. Voilà. So the curd had a little time for itself. See, it's much thicker. And you're gonna just pour it into your tart cases you done earlier. But on your tart cases, you put some egg wash. Like that is a bit more waterproof. You won't get the dampness of the curd, if you know what I mean. So the pastry will stay crunchy. Voilà, simple. So you can make big or small one, no problem. Well, that was a good guess. I didn't know how many we will be doing. Actually, we can do a little bit more even. There we go. So now we're gonna let it set in the fridge. And once it sets, so we can glaze it, or we can torch it, whatever the finish you want to give it for it. Voilà, that's all. Okay, so basically, that's our lemon tart. Now it's set, it's been in the fridge like for 4 hours. That's how we serve it in our shop, a fruit glaze jelly and with a little thin line of chocolate, and that does our job. Or you can finish it with icing sugar on top. If you put some icing sugar on top like that, and then you finish it with the blue torch, it's gonna caramelize it. Some people like it like that as well. Let's do another one. There we go. So which one do you prefer? They're both beautiful. That's all.